This video introduces how to complete the hand-eye calibration, also extrinsic parameter calibration in the eye-in-hand setup. In the eye-in-hand setup, the installation method places the camera fixed on the robot's end flange. For the eye-in-hand setup, the extrinsic parameters represent the transformation between the camera and the flange reference frames. In this video, we will obtain this transformation using calibration wizard in Mech-Vision on a 6-axis robot. Thus, vision system can use the calibration result in guiding the robot to perform picking. The communication mode in this video is standard interface communication. Now, let's start the calibration. First, let's begin with the pre-calibration checks. Check the robot. Securely mount the robot base and make sure there's no wobble in the robot body. Check the robot absolute accuracy. For this, check the zero positions for their accuracy. If they are inaccurate, please recalibrate. Move the robot a certain distance along a fixed direction in the workstation. Measure the actual movement distance. Compare it with the distance displayed on the teach pendant. A smaller difference means a higher robot accuracy. When the absolute accuracy cannot meet the sight requirements, please contact the robot manufacturer. In the scenario of eye-in-hand setup, ensure that the camera is securely attached to the flange at the end of robot. Next, check the calibration board. Make sure that the circles of the calibration board are clearly visible without obvious scratches, and the board does not suffer from deformations. Place the calibration board in the working area. Additionally, move the robot above the calibration board, adjusting the robot's pose to align the camera lens with the calibration board. Next, open Mech-Eye Viewer, connect the camera, and ensure that the calibration board is centered in the camera's field of view. After establishing the initial pose, let's proceed to adjust the exposure parameters. First, select the Calib parameter group. The 2D image is dark and the 3D point clouds are defective. So, adjust 2D and 3D exposure parameters accordingly, and then we have the complete point cloud and the clear 2D image. Next, start calibration. Open Mech-Vision. Create a solution and save it. Click Camera Calibration. So far, we have finished the pre-calibration checks. So, choose I've finished all checks and click Next. Select New Calibration, then click Next. Choose Hand-Eye Calibration for listed robot. Click Select Robot Model, then choose the model of the robot in use. In this video, we are using FANUC LR Mate 200 ID. Click Next. Select Camera Setup, Eye in Hand. Click Next. Select Calibration Method and Robot Control, Automatic and Standard Interface respectively. Choose Calibrate and enter the calibration interface. First, connect to a camera. Find the camera to connect in the detected cameras list. In this video, we are using Mech-Eye Nano. Click the Connect button. Click Next. Select the calibration board model. In this case, we use BDB5. Under Check Calibration Board Position and Point Cloud Quality, read carefully the requirements. Afterwards, click Capture Continually to see actual images captured by the camera. Move the robot according to the prompt indicating the distance between the calibration board and the camera. Additionally, make sure the calibration board is in the red rectangle. Click Stop Capturing and Detect Position. And on the teach pendant, press Select to choose the program. Press Enter to select MM Auto Calib. And move the cursor to the first line of the program. Make sure the IP address here is the same as the IP address of the IPC. Then move the cursor to the fifth line, which is the position register, and switch the position type to Cartesian. Then press Shift and Touch Up to record the current position. We can see the position has been recorded, shown on the screen. Check the quality of the calibration board's point cloud. If the point cloud is poor, open Mech-Eye Viewer to adjust the exposure parameters and repeat the previous steps. In Check Intrinsic Parameters, click Check Intrinsic Parameters. If the camera intrinsic parameter check passes, click OK in the pop-up window. Click Next and move on to the next step, connect the robot. Click Start Interface Service. On the teach pendant, move the cursor to the first line of the program. Turn the switch of the teach pendant to off, and turn the switch of the controller to auto. Now the robot is in automatic mode. Press reset on the teach pendant to clear any errors, and then press the cycle start button to auto-run the calibration program. Back in Mech-Vision, you can see that the robot has successfully connected. Next, set motion path. In Determine Range for Calibration, set the Height Range parameter. Click Auto-Generate, then Confirm in the pop-up window. This operation will slightly move the robot and capture images. It may take 10 to 15 seconds. After this, in the pop-up Calibration window, click OK. In the Scene Viewer panel on the right, confirm that waypoints are reasonable and will not collide with obstacles. Then, click Generate Path based on parameters. After setting the motion path, click Next. In Obtain Images and Poses, select Get Pose from Real Robot. Click Robot Pose Type and ensure that the JPEG of the robot is the same as that on the teach pendant. While ensuring the path is collision-free and the robot runs at a safe speed, click Start Calibration to collect data. Wait until the robot finishes moving along the preset path and the camera finishes capturing images on all waypoints. After all images are captured, click OK in the pop-up window. Click Next to enter step Calculate Extrinsic Parameters. Click Calculate Extrinsic Parameters, we can get the calibration result. Click Check Report on Extrinsic Parameter Calibration. The Extrinsic Parameter Calibration Report will be automatically displayed after it is generated. Here, the results of the Euler Angle Convention check, camera accuracy check, and robot absolute accuracy check will be presented. If the calibration result is less than satisfactory, you can follow the guidance in the auxiliary tool to troubleshoot factors causing extrinsic parameter errors. For detailed operations, please refer to the documentation. Click Save, the calibration result will be saved in the Calibration folder within the project directory. Now, we have completed hand-eye calibration in eye-in-hand setup. Guided by the calibration result, the robot can now proceed to perform picking. You can refer to our documentation to learn more operations about the hand-eye calibration in eye-in-hand setup.